I was watching the news last night and they said the free market is responsible for the economic crisis. And that we need more government regulation. Is this true?
No, it is not, because we do not really have a free market economy. In fact, that is the problem. If we had a free market economy, we would not be in this mess.
What do you mean we do not have a free market economy?
In a free market, the price of a good is set based on the supply and demand of that good. The government does not manipulate the price of goods in a free market.
So that means that we do have a free market economy. I bought milk just yesterday and the price of milk was not manipulated by the government. I also bought broccoli, shoes, a new winter coat and a lot of other stuff. The government did not get involved.
The price of those goods is not manipulated by the government. But there is one good of which the government does manipulate the price. And this good is the most important good in the economy.
Which good is that?
Money.
Did you say money? Money is a good? And it has a price?
Yes. Money is the most important good in the economy. And the price of money is the interest that is charged to borrow the money.
Oh, okay. I understand. The price of money is the interest that is charged to borrow it. So, like other goods, the price of money should be set based on the supply and demand of money.
Exactly. Banks are the sellers, in this case. They charge a fee to lend money, and this fee, the interest rate, should be determined based on the supply and demand. Allow me to explain how this works in a truly free market economy. Let's go to a conference room. Now let's pretend you are a banker.
Okay.
Now let's pretend you have only a little bit of money, so your supply is low. You want more people to deposit money, so that you can lend it out. What would you do to encourage your customers to deposit more money?
Raise the interest rate?
Exactly. You would raise the interest rate to encourage your customers to deposit more money. The more they save, the more they make. Now, let's pretend a lot of customers started saving money to take advantage of the high interest rate, and you now have a lot of money. You want to make money, so you want businesses to borrow money from you. What do you do to encourage businesses to borrow money from you?
Well, I would do what any other business would do when it has a high supply of a product and not enough people willing to buy at the current price. I would lower the price of my product.
That is correct. You would lower the interest rate to encourage borrowing. Because of this, the interest rate serves a very important function.
And what is that?
The interest rate serves as a signal to businesses. When the interest rate is low, it means consumers, in general, are saving a lot of money. When the interest rate is high, it means consumers are not saving enough money.
Why is that important?
Because if you are a business person and you want to borrow money to invest in future products, you want to make sure consumers are saving money for the future. If consumers are not saving money, it means that the moment they would rather spend money in the present, instead of in the future. In this type of scenario, businesses should not be borrowing money to invest in the future, because consumers will not have money saved in the future to consume their products.
Okay. That makes sense. Businesses should borrow and invest when consumers are saving a lot of money, not when consumers are spending all their money now.
Correct. But businesses don't have to figure out whether consumers are saving or not, because the interest rate serves as the signal. When the rate is low, businesses will borrow and invest, and this is good, because it means consumers are also saving.
So this works perfectly. The banker charges a rate, based on how much consumer savings exist, and businesses will coincidentally borrow at the right time. So what is the problem?
Well, this is how a free market would work. But like I said before, we do not have a free market because the government manipulates the interest rates.
How does the government manipulate the rates?
The Federal Reserve can lend money to the banks at a very low rate, if it wants to.
And why is that a problem? If I'm a banker, this is good. I want money so that I can lend it out.
The problem is that you, the banker, now have a lot of money to lend, but not because consumers are saving. You have money to lend because the Federal Reserve gave it to you. And since you now have a lot of money to lend, you, the banker, will lower the interest rate. Remember that the interest rate serves as a signal to businesses.
Oh. I see the problem now. If I lower the interest rate, businesses will think it is a good time to invest because money is cheap at the moment.
Correct.
Interest rates are supposed to be low when consumers are saving. And they are supposed to be high when consumers are not saving.
Correct.
So the Federal Reserve manipulates the signal to businesses by lending me, the banker, money. The signal is now a false signal. Businesses will incorrectly think savings exist.
Exactly. Having low savings by consumers, and low interest rates at the same time is very dangerous. Businesses will borrow a lot of money, invest in big future projects, and hire more people to work on those future projects.
But isn't that good? The Federal Reserve, in this case, has helped to create jobs.
Well, the problem is that these jobs were created under false pretenses. It's an artificial boom that will be followed by a bust. What will happen when businesses spend all of that money and time expanding, and then realize that their projects are not profitable?
I see. They will lay some people off, because they cannot afford them.
Correct. In economics, this is called the business cycle. Businesses waste money and time expanding at the wrong time.
So the Federal Reserve is responsible for the destruction of those jobs, and for the losses of the businesses.
Yes.
So businesses would have been better off not expanding, and waiting until consumers started saving again, before investing.
Correct. Which brings me to my other point. Because the Federal Reserve caused the rates to be lowered, consumers are not encouraged to save.
Oh shit. So not only is the Federal Reserve responsible for deceiving businesses, but in this case, they are also responsible for discouraging consumers from saving.
Correct.
This is not good.
No, it is not.
Wait a second. Where does the Federal Reserve get the money that they use to manipulate the interest rates and mess up the economy?
They create it out of thin air.
What do you mean out of thin air?
Since the dollar is not backed by anything, they can just create it by printing it, or by creating it electronically in a computer.
You cannot be serious.
I am very serious. And because the Federal Reserve is introducing new money into the economy, this causes higher prices.
So, if in a truly free market, the interest rates get correctly set based on the supply and demand of money, why does the Federal Reserve feel the need to manipulate the rates?
Because they think they are so smart, that they know where the interest rate should be in order to stimulate the economy.
But we don't need anyone, smart or not, to set the interest rates. They would work just fine, if they were left alone, just like the price of computers is left up to the market.
Exactly. But politicians are very arrogant, and they never learn from past mistakes, and most are not even interested in learning economics.
So our economic problems are created because of the arrogance and ignorance of politicians, who refuse to realize that things would work better if they left the economy alone.
Yes, exactly.
That makes me very angry.
What are you going to do about it?
Well, I can start by not voting for politicians who are ignorant of economics.
Excellent idea.